my channel. If it's your first time being on this channel, kindly use the subscribe button. Let me say it in the language some of you understand, in case you don't understand what I said. I beg, if not the first time where you did come for this channel, you go see one button where they write subscribe. Just click on the button to subscribe and you're going to get info whenever I post videos for this YouTube channel. So how's it been, guys? What's been happening? In fact, where do I even start from? You know, okay. For those of you who do not know, this vlog or this YouTube channel started as a result of wanting to talk about Big Brother. So now that Big Brother is over, until Big Brother is over, I will actually talk about it. In fact, if you don't know, Big Brother is not over. This is the real double wahala. If you've been on social media in the last 1 week, it's been one thing or the other. In fact, even the house didn't have as much drama as this. At least in the house, the only drama we saw was between the, what's it called, Toby and Sissy. But this one, just they touch everybody body. So where do we start from today? I like to write down what I want to talk about so I don't forget anything. Okay, Laura's box. Laura's box is like, I don't like calling it a blog because, I don't know, started as a hobby, like till now it's still something I'm not, it's not something I'm, it's not like a business, so it's still like a baby to me. So I don't know, I don't like calling it a blog, but let me just call it a blog. So what we'll do is talk about TV shows, like do a bit of recap, or let's just interact on the TV shows we're currently watching. Now, I am not very experimental. I don't watch most TV shows. I like Nollywood, Nigerian stuff, African Magic. So I'm presently watching two series on African Magic Showcase. It's called Ajoche and Forbidden. I talked about it last week. So I'm Telemundo, oh my God, I love Telemundo so much. You don't want to understand. I always say, in fact, in my second mind, the mind at the back, I feel I'm not a Nigerian. I'm probably from one of those European countries like Mexico, Spain, Colombia, Venezuela. So I love Telemundo a lot. So if you actually love Telemundo, trust me, this is where you should be, because we talk about it and every other thing, you know, like trending topics. So today we're going to talk about trending topics, like what's been trending, what has been trending. But let me start by running the lines on the series. So Ajoche, what's been happening in Ajoche last week? What happened in Ajoche last week? Okay, you know the boy now. The boy, the king seed from Abo, that the little baby. So he actually grew up. Yeah, I've talked about that 2 weeks ago. And they gave him, guess the name, Ash. But finally, which are very, in fact, like I told you guys, the child actors really impressed me. Like I have not, it's been a long time I saw kids who, like, they are not known, like it's basically the first time I'm seeing them act, and they are relatively young, and they are very articulate, very confident. You know, the king is already very drawn to the little boy, that's Ashes, which his name is also actually Alechenu. I'm sure if I do, but you understand all these names, Alechenu, title the unexpected one. So the king is actually really drawn to the boy. Of course, Ashes saved his life the previous week. By now you know that the king's brother, General Ape, is the one who killed the third wife. Now, the king's daughter is actually very ambitious. She wants to be the queen. Apparently, there was a time a female or a woman assumed the role of the king in that village. And so she told her father, so why are you worried? Like, I can actually be the queen. So I think because of that ambition, she doesn't like adopted brother, that's Ashes. Now, somehow, General Ape convinced the elders and the chief priest to tell the king to nominate his own son as the future Odaleko, like the future king of Ocholuje, and he actually did. So that's like basically what happened last week. You know, of course, he has already anointed, his name is Epe, that's General's son, to be the king. I still don't understand what this girl is trying to do. The girl that was sleeping with the king, actually she seduced the king's brother and she slept with him. She vanished for like 5 years and came back. I still don't understand if it's a game or if there's something she's looking for. You know, she's generally from, she's what's it called? Actually from Abo. She just migrated into Ocholuje. So that's it for Ajoche. What do you think? I don't know. I've not been able to like pinpoint, or when it comes to series, I have a way of like guessing what the storyline would be like. But for Adjoche, I really do not know what they are trying to do. If you know, let me find out. Then Forbidden, like I told you guys, I enjoyed Forbidden the first 2 days, but I don't know what's going on. It's not. There's something off for me. The acting is very stiff. Oh my god, I'm sorry. The girl playing the role of Becky, which is Toni Torrance, you can barely hear her talk. I don't know if she had the sore throat when she was shooting that scene. I think that's probably, it's actually a possibility. But you can actually, you can barely hear her talk. She's always, you know, even the things that don't need, I'm sad. She's overly too sexy, even when there's no need. Then the outfits they use for the office wears. They go off, let's say they wear body con, nets, like everywhere is open. So the office, are you kidding me? Or they wear one nice, it's just very off. Like a lot of things are off. Then for the names, I saw a friend of mine tweeting yesterday saying they've not been able to make up their minds if it is Daregos, Dorego or Doregos, which is true. Because you see the people, oh, my name is Demilade Doregos. Now, if you look at the character cast, it's actually called Doregos. I hear some people saying Daregos. For instance, Eliton, played by Teresa Edim, I know she's not a Yoruba girl, but in the movie, in the series, she's acting like a Yoruba girl, Eliton, Olaonitekun. And you cannot pronounce the name Demilade. Hi, Demi. Excuse me, it's not Demi. It's Demi, not Demi. Hi, Demi. Demi Darego. And I'm like, you guys are the one acting this thing. It won't take anything for you to just learn the pronunciation of those words or those names. Very simple. Demilade Doregos. Easy peasy. So, like, quite a lot of things are off. For me, the person doing it right now is the guy playing Timmy. And that's that Charles, the 2BAB guy. Like, he's really, he's not overdoing it. He's actually being very real. Like, he's one character you can actually relate to. Then I like Jide Rambo, even though I'm not particularly convinced with his acting. I'm not saying, I don't know they can also act. I know I've done like a couple of movies. I'm just saying, but the guy is actually very funny, like extremely funny. Hopefully, I know to pick up like Battleground last season. We watched about 60 episodes before Battleground picked up. So, of course, I think it's something we're used to. So, I expect it to pick up. Adachi is not doing badly. I just hope they continue with the tempo. That's for Africa Magic Showcase series. Then on Telemundo Ground, Lord of the Skies, Aurelio, God have mercy. I think that guy is worse than Yoruba Demon. You know, they see woman saying no, like every woman he sees he wants to sleep with. And now you guys are talking about, oh, they show it like 10 p.m. I think you need to understand they show that movie like 10 p.m. It's actually strong language, serious violence, and serious intimacy. Like in the last 1 week, I've watched their sex scenes, and up to 1 point, the side boobs they show, the expressions, I don't think it would be nice for them to show it anything less than 10, to be honest. Like, it's excessive, serious, strong language, excessive violence, intimacy is quite explicit. So, I think if you can watch it or you record it, if you have an explorer, it's not bad at all. It's not bad at all. Aurelio never says no to any woman. Every woman is my queen. Even if you are selling orange on the road, Aurelio sees you immediately. Oh, hi, my queen. How much is your tray of oranges? Everybody's his queen. He's so badly behaved. And he has a wife. Then his sister-in-law, his brother's wife, is seducing and kissing his son. Like, I can't even wait for that. I don't even know what's going to happen, because right now in the US, they're currently showing season 6, and we're just watching season 1, and we have about 450 episodes to get to season 6. I don't know how they want to do, but trust me, it's something you want to see. The guy is like a drug lord, that's Aurelio Casillas, very wicked, very selfish, you know. He doesn't want any other person to prosper. You know how they have different cartels, like the Juarez cartel, the Jalisco cartel. I'm really surprised. Just as I'm pronouncing it the way it's called, the Jalisco cartel, the Juarez cartel, and everything. But he wants to take over everything. Like, he's supposed to have a friend in the army who is helping him. Jimenez Arroyo. and he's trying to blackmail that one. The guy is just a nuisance, like a complete asshole. So that's for Lord of the Skies. Then for Blood and Wine, it's pretty it's a very short telenovela, just 53 episodes. So in no time, in like 2 months or a month, it's over. Now, I don't know, who do you think is setting one up? I suspect Roberto. Now, Roberto is a guy who is very quiet, who looks very unassuming, that proposed to Aurora, but she said no. I don't know how he's actually perpetuating the evil, rather. I just spoke like a Yoruba girl, perpetuating the evil. Because I actually said he killed the guy in the hospital. What was his name? That guy that is in prison of fame that would never act, oh no, somebody mentioned my office, that would never shoot a movie without dying in the first episode. He did that in this particular episode too. I think he poisoned him, but with time we'll get there. So presently the telenovelas I watch, Lord of the Skies, Blood and Wine, and La Patrona. Most of you have seen La Patrona. It's actually an old telenovela, but just showing it on DSTV. You know Araceli Arambula, she's actually the protagonist, and playing the character of Gabriela. Then we have Alejandro, Fernando, I don't even know. Just when you watch, and let's see if we can talk about it in the next episode of this vlog. So now let's get to Big Brother Niger. Before getting to Big Brother Niger, I told you guys about Rimbai last week. Omo, the love is growing now. The love is growing seriously. So the love is actually growing. Like I told you guys, like, look at his post yesterday. He just posted a very sweet picture of himself and Rimbai. Very soon, we are all going to Zimbabwe to marry a wife. Not Misha, but we, Naija, going to Zimbabwe to marry a wife. Like, I'm really happy for her. I like love. Trust me, I love love stories. I love when a woman is being, you know, your man is not scared to love, show it, throw it out to the world. And in this instance, we already see pictures on Vimbai's page. But if you go to, he's actually a very private person. So I don't know, for most of them, I'm sure some of you know him already. If you don't know him, sorry. I don't like revealing those things, but I know he's actually a very private person. So I would have told his page, but I'll post it. Don't worry, I'm looking at the picture right now. You must see it. You can see it. So don't worry, I'll bring you all the other people you need to see. I'll put it there for you to see. Now that's for Sweet Oracle. Zainab got married yesterday too. Yesterday being Sunday. Being Sunday. She got married. You know Zainab now, the Nollywood actress. She was in wedding party, the wedding planner, and the TV presenter on Ebony Life TV. She got married. I know she was so hush-hush about it. No hashtags. No pre-engagement, this thing. And that's like me, because I tell my friends, when it's time for me to get married, I'm not going to have an hashtag until my reception. When I get to the reception, we'll now put like, I won't tell you my secrets, but I'm going to have my hashtag when I get to my reception. I don't think I want a pre-wedding picture yet. I would have a pre-wedding picture, but I won't post it till after my wedding. That's what I intend to do. So it's actually very beautiful seeing the secret, you know. Nobody knew apart from my close friends. I'm sure she would have told them, if I hear him about this wedding, I'll disinvite you. So nobody knew until yesterday. No hashtag, nothing at all. And her husband is a billionaire in this day and age. The big girl carry better eye go market, because you see, you have to marry well. I keep telling people, Mio, I want to marry a rich man. I don't know about you. I want to marry a rich man. Like, the guy is a dude. He's done well for himself. He used to work with Aero. He was a special advisor to Abia State governor. So you will not even be shocked that maybe in a few years, he will be the governor of Abia State. And Zainab will be the first lady. Can you imagine? Let's welcome our first lady, Zainab Balogun Achiku. So you see, the guy is actually like the CEO of Jet West Africa. He's been married before, but unfortunately he lost his wife in 2015, so this is the second time getting married, and he has 2 kids. So, you know, getting married to a mature man, I wish him had the absolute best. Zainab is a very sweet girl from what we see. I don't think she's fame crazy, no noise, she's just living her life, the way it is, no controversy, no scandal. So I'm actually rooting for this marriage. Like, I wish her the best. Hi Zainab, this is wishing you the best, and I'm sure the people watching are also wishing you the absolute best. So that's for Zainab. Now let's enter Twitter. What's been happening on Twitter? Now, a lot has happened in the last week. Some I'll talk about and some I don't give a rat ass talk about, trust me. So let me talk about the ones I'll talk about. Twitter Oracle. You all know Twitter Oracle support. Now I'm going to play the devil's advocate here. I'm going to be for and against everybody. This is how I'm thinking. Like, since it came out, this is exactly what's been going through my head. So I'm going to talk for and I'm going to talk against. Now, some people talking about Twitter Oracle, you know. First of all, there was this thing, this long speech. I'll see if I can post it here. I don't know if I can. Long write-up, Twitter Oracle talking about how when Miracle won, he never said thank you, or he left wherever he was for 6 hours to come to Lagos. In fact, somebody said he sat at the reception for 6 hours before seeing Miracle. Hey, God. First of all, what are you looking for? Let's start with that. I've been watching Big Brother for like more than 10 years. I cannot even... This is not me bragging, though. But you see how very intense and very passionate I am with Big Brother. The moment that show is over, don't finish, don't expire. Like, before it even said expire, it don't evaporate. Like, I can't see myself, first of all, going to the airport to welcome people. This is no... I'm not faulting those of you going to the airport, but you see, I don't know what else. Like, how can you sit down in the reception lobby for 6 hours to see who? Barry or good luck? Like, it's not going to give you anything at the end of the day. Nothing at all. Like, till tomorrow, with how everything, the only Big Brother housemate I have seen that we eventually became friends was Tyro. And it just happened by chance. That is a sweet guy. Apart from that, it's no other person. So I don't know how, first of all, Twitter Oracle will live where he, I don't even know where he lived. I actually thought he was based in Lagos. I don't know where he's based. Came to Lagos and he sat in the lobby, according to what's been going around on Twitter, for 6 hours. First of all, you said, oh, they didn't tell you thank you appropriately, they didn't call you. Now, as much as, you know, you don't do things because you want thank you, but for somebody who went out of his way, like Twitter Oracle, who was almost a complete nuisance, because you know the game, he played really dirty. You know, he would malign other housemates, he played a very dirty game, which is always, that's what he does. He doesn't play fair and square, he's always playing dirty to support his housemates. You know, that did everything, that put his integrity on the line. Whatever integrity he has, I really don't know. At least a simple, and you have direct access to him, not like me. Like, most times I don't have access to these people. That's just the truth. I don't think I've ever had access with anybody before like this at all. You have direct access. You call, you guys talk on the phone every other time. And trust me, you talk on the phone. Because towards the last week, I'm going to say this for the first time. You know, towards the last, what's it called? The last week of Big Brother. As much as, okay, I supported Teddy and Teddy was out of the house. And for me, you know, I have this, there were only two people I honestly did not want to win. I'm sure you know them. You know, so for the remaining three, I love Nina, but it looked like she didn't stand a chance. Even though at the end of the day, I splitted my votes between Sisi, Nina, and Miracle. Sisi very little votes. Nina and Miracle almost at par votes, you understand? And I still stand there and say I really wanted Miracle to win, because of course it's something we all know. Miracle was arrogant in the house. I said it a number of times. Miracle was cocky in the house. I said it a number of times. And I don't have a problem with you being arrogant or with you being cocky. That's your problem. After all, they called Teddy cocky, or they called him arrogant. Honestly, I have no problem with that. So I really didn't mind. The only thing I applauded Miracle for was, I think when it came to playing the game, apart from the person who I supported leaving, it was the next person. He wasn't really playing a very dirty game. And he was actually very hardworking, so I didn't mind him winning. So, you know, a few days to the final week, I don't know who gave his brother my number. And he called and he was like, oh, what's up? I learned you supported this person. look, can you support my brother? And I told him, I said, support your brother. Personally, I actually think your brother is going to win. But you know, you guys played a very dirty game. So if you could reach out to me that wasn't even on his team, you can imagine what I'm trying to talk about. He actually had a direct access to Twitter Oracle. Now, after the game, he's not going to take you anything by calling him to say thank you for everything. For see, it's not easy to support Big Brother housemates. So let me, I'm sure you know, those of you who put your life or your name on the line, it's actually not easy, because anyhow you want, whatever you see is what you get. So that guy was ready to play in the mud. I can say thank you. But you know, as much as when you're doing things, so you don't do things for thank you. So for both of them, I don't know who to fault. I'm not going to fault any of them. You know, on one hand, I would say, Oracle, you don't, you know, if you like someone, you like him for whatever it is you want to do. Then again, if he's a businessman, you don't expect thank you. And you know, in the write-up, it was like, most of you do not know the rude and arrogant and cocky American. And I'm like, excuse me, no. You were the ones I don't think Miracle pretended. I think the only place he acted was maybe when it came to Mina, the relationship, which it wasn't even a pretense. If you look very well, you can see that Miracle wasn't exactly into Mina like that. It was just a convenient fork. Sorry to use that word. How do I censor that word now? Okay, a convenient shag. You know when somebody's a convenient shag to you? I think that was what Miracle and Nina was all about. I don't think it was anything deep. And which, it was even only the blind that didn't want to see it. It was obvious that was it for Miracle. We also had the way he spoke to Nina anyhow. He could really, so it was just a matter of convenience. Oh, she did, yeah. If I say I want this thing, she will give me. Why not? And that was it. And that is how I saw it to be. So when people say, this one, that one, I'm like, well, that one is for Twitter Oracle. And of course, the bashing started. Those for Twitter Oracle, those for Miracle. Then the next thing, hey, God, this is what ever shocked me. When we're in the house, in fact, look at the screen, you'll see it right now. Just look at the screen, you'll see me posting it right now. You know, I've always said, Miracle looks like a sugar mommy special. He looks like a boy that, you know, he's very obedient, like baby boy chomp. He will ask you how high when it comes to following older women. And for, I said it twice or three times during the show. And I was actually not surprised when I heard he had a sugar mommy, but I was shocked that it was Juliet. Because when we were in the house on Val's day, Big Brother said, oh, do you have anybody you want to say anything to? Of course, Lulu said, let me check again. Lulu said, Dodo. And Miracle said Juliet. And everybody, who is Juliet? Who is Juliet? Who is Juliet? Who is Juliet? We all thought it was one small young girl. We did not know that it was one spicy mommy, if the rumors are true. But it looks true because her pictures are everywhere. She's Miracle's sugar mommy. Oh, some people, don't worry, believe me, I have first hand information according to people posting it. And I trust my belief. Because the coincidence, I don't know, from Juliet to Auntie Juliet, who is a godmother. You know how it is these days now. He's my chairman, he's your boyfriend. Oh, he's my this thing. So he's not far-fetched by his own, she's my godmother. People sleep with their godmothers now. Oh, Miracle, you're doing big things, boy. See, I don't have a problem with anybody dating anybody's sugar mommy. That's not my problem. It's when it comes to, like I always say, whatever an adult decides to do with their vagina and their prick, it's not concerning me. So Miracle, are you big up? Then there are accusations of Nina fans being bitter and they're the ones revealing all these secrets. I don't know the ones being bitter. I mean, I feel like a couple of them, and I like Nina. I'm not bitter. My own is Nina. If Miracle decides to buy you a car, please collect that car and keep it. That's all the... Forget sex. Sex is even very minute, because I'm sure they enjoyed it together. The emotional sacrifice, being there for him, the time spent, making yourselves each other's company. I think Nina was very symbiotic to Miracle's winning, because without Nina, you would almost not place Miracle to anything in that house. In fact, since he came out of the house, half of these controversies, he's been like, DOA. You know, they hear anything about him. So without Nina, you would almost not hear anything about Miracle, apart from the fact that oh, you won this task. There was nothing, no controversy. There was, you can't place a significant thing on anything. So trust me, all of you that are saying, yeah, who is Nina? Nina actually, it was a very symbiotic relationship for the both of them. And while I thought I was still digesting the Auntie Juliet and God, in fact, somebody even said that, oh God, this other boy is too much. In fact, I can't even begin to post what I saw on Twitter yesterday. Some said, oh, the brothers are sleeping with one woman. Different things, you know, and that's my fear about Big Brother. It's my sister, I don't have a sister who wants to go to Big Brother. My sister is way older than I am, so she wants to wake up now and say, Laura, I'm going for Big Brother. If I had a sister who called me one day to say, Laura, I'm going for Big Brother, I would tie her up. On that audition day, I would tie her. Because, you see, the insult or the backlash will affect you as a family member. Look at Alex, the people insult her mom. Oh, her mother is sitting down here. Your daughter is doing this. Your daughter is not doing that. You know, all those things. Look at Miracle now. People dragging his brother. Oh, his brothers don't have anything to do. Busy following the brother about. Oh, they're sleeping with different women. Like, who knew these people before? Nobody knew them before. But look at Big Brother. Like, I'm legit scared of that show. I'm not going to lie to you. My enemy. As much as I love Big Brother, I would not even advise my enemy to go for that show. It's an unnecessary way of opening your lives to people, like to vile human beings. If you think the housemates are vile, we need to meet the fans. If you just go to the explore page on your Instagram and see what people write when it comes to Big Brother, you'll be like, wow, like, are you joking? Friends fight, like close friends fighting because of Big Brother. Different things, like it's a crazy show. While I was still trying to assimilate Sugar Mommy, Sugar Brother, Baby Boo, Twitter Oracle, MC Galaxy came with his own. Oh, I supported him in the house because he was humble. I'm like, excuse me, who said he was humble? Who called Miracle humble? Humble from where to where? He just did not talk about himself. That was all the boy did not do. And which is a very good trick. Just come, don't say anything. He just did not, like, unlike Leo. Oh, I did this, PhD, I went to FHR, I went to this. Miracle, you know, you're not nothing. So when they come and say it was home, like, Nigerians was like on this false humility. Nigerians, the one who came and said, oh, I lived in the US, I did this, I worked here, they said he was washing toilets, they said he was cocky, he was arrogant. The one who said, oh, I did this, oh, she did this, but the one who did not say this is humble. This boy was, I don't know how it works. Which humility, like, there was nothing like humility and Miracle in that house. When they come and say, I thought you were humble, but that's your own perception about him, according to, what's her name? Yeah, I can't remember. But she's always saying perception, that's your own perception, do you understand? About him, that's what you think. He didn't come to tell you, oh, I am humble or something, do you understand? So MC Galaxy was not like, I thought you were humble, I spoke to Imoni to actually vote you, I won't be able to say thank you, which is bad. Because that night, I remember there was even an overnight voting at Imoni's place. I saw the picture where the brother came, like, took a picture with Casey and was like, oh my God, thank you very much, bros, all the overnight voting we did. And you can imagine how much they've spent. You know Imoni has money, and if he wants to support you, can you ask a simple thank you or call? You don't even have to go there, like, hi, good afternoon, sir. Of course, maybe your mate. Well done, sir. Oh, thank you very much. I heard you. When I threw my media around, I would come and see you. You don't even have to go and see him. That is just the truth. See, courtesy is very important. Anybody bringing out money, I vote for Big Brother, so I know how much it takes to spend. See, 1 million cannot even give you, on the final day, 1 million votes, like 1 million naira, cannot give you 5% votes. No jokes. Not like anybody tell you for. I tell you anything, 1 million naira votes will not give you 5% of Big Brother's voting portal. So it's a huge deal when people come out to stick out there. The least you can do is take, take they kill anybody now, that's the least you can do. Then there was this other thing too. They said, oh, Twitter Apple chopped money. And I'm like, okay, I don't know about that. This money is a very bad thing, like very, very, very bad thing. Like, it's very bad. At the end of the day, Miracle won. So you cannot, when somebody won, you won. You don't have access to Big Brother's voting portal. So how are you sure you stole the money? At every point in time, it was up for, what's it called? For nomination. He topped the votes. He topped. So when you come and say he chopped our money, I'm wondering how. Because if you're going to be complaining that, oh, he didn't win, so he chopped our money, the guy won. Hands down. With almost 10. Listen, maybe they were expecting him to win like Efe. It's not possible. Efe and Miracle had different. When people try to compare to Efe, I always laugh. I laugh. I have nothing to say because I don't think I can compare the both of them. If they had, like, see, people who were going to die on the line for him, so it was normal for his percentage to just bust out. Miracle had his fans, but not like, if you let anybody deceive you, it wasn't like FA zone. So when people say, oh, do you have, like, a proof to show that? I'm sure by now you know that I'm not a fan of Oracle, so this is me just being a devil's advocate, like, for and against, do you understand? But that's for this thing. And on Instagram, I don't know who, hey God, somebody went to open an Instagram page, titled it Flower Girls, Miracle, Miracle, Girls Want to Sleep in Miracle, used very dirty words. And so if you're on Twitter and you support Miracle and you're very vocal about Miracle, you'll just remount your picture and put it on that Instagram and write, hey God, let me just hold on, let me see if I can find it, and write, meet this, so even married people were there. Even married people were there. Like, how do you put a married woman's picture on social media and write she wants to sleep a miracle? Seeing flower girls, like, how? Like, this show is just making us lose one thing or the other. Like, seeing flower girls, how do you do that? Let me see if I can find something. Like, find a caption. I can't. It's on that phone. I saw it 2 days ago and I was like, wow. Like, it's actually not nice at all, because you see people who are, this is not a crime to support anybody. Then you put up a married woman's picture, like, just because she's supporting someone, and you put it on, what's it called, on social media, and you put the caption, oh, it's in flower girls. You want to open your pin for Miracle. They will just sleep with you and dump you. Like, over 100 pictures of different women, single, married, old, young. Like, I don't think this show just get us to be, to be honest. And you know, that's it for the Miracle, the Mina, the Lina situation, and his family members. Finally, Alex is going home today, but she's probably on her way home. For those of you who have been asked, you know, when is she going to go to her house? When she's on go out, so she's going home today. So at least if she don't go out, everybody will rest. For who else? Everybody's just living their lives. The housemates are, you know, living their lives. At the end of this video, I'm going to leave you with a video that D1 posted early this morning. I woke up and it was actually very funny. So if it's funny to you, laugh with me. I'll post at the end of this video. What's been happening on Twitter? Over the weekend, we had this Yahoo Boys thing where people talked about Yahoo, Nobuligwe talked about. For me, I just thought that tweet was just an innocent tweet. It's normal people tweet about almost stores, you know, there are lots of stores coming up right now on the island, even on the mainland. And most times empty, or you won't even see one person. And just like, okay, most of these stores are used for money laundering or Yahoo, and people just went mad. You know, I don't know what has happened in this world where you openly come out to support something like this. Nobody does. Even if you're doing Yahoo, you hide it. You don't openly come out to support. I know we had young people on Twitter. You know, the one that even annoyed me were these Big Brother housemates. Example, Efe, asking silly questions like, your politician and your this. Even Kebule. No, Kebule does. No one doesn't have sense right on time. You come out to make excuses for fraudsters. See, for me, the moment you are on TV, you're an ambassador, because whether you see it or not, some of you will say, I'm not your role model, don't make me your role model, which is very understandable. People don't force you to be their role model, but once you are there, you're signed up for a role model. There are people who look up to you in any way possible. There are people who see you and say, oh, I like FA's dexterity, I like Efe's hard work. Okay, Brule, I like the fact that he's goofy, even though I can't really pinpoint on one thing that I did in the house and everything. So whatever it is you do or you say, it has to be very careful, like properly worded. And you come out and you make excuses for fraudsters. Like, it was actually very annoying yesterday when I saw it, like, really stupid. The certain things you don't do, you don't say, you should not be seen or heard. Call it living a fake life. But you could just hide one. Like, you don't just show it. You don't show it at all. You just have to, like, stay in the confines of your room and just do it. Or your mind, you have those thoughts, just swallow it. Don't come out to say it. And they actually did. And of course, trust Twitter or trust social media. They got the backlash for it. So that's it. For me, when it comes to fraud, you know, right from time, even while growing up, I like money. And I've always told myself that, first of all, apart from love and respect, security is one thing that is very paramount to me. Now, security in the sense that I can be dating a fraudster and I know he's a fraudster, and one day, EFCC, police will just enter in house and they will carry me. Before I will say, oh, sir, I'm not though, I'm just his girlfriend. I'll see my picture on Insta Blog Ninja, on Facebook. Those things I can't stand. I see, I have shame they catch me, die, like those things. Right from time, I've always been very security conscious. Everything like that, so many things you would really want to do. There were things I honestly wanted to dabble into or do. These guys are very flashy. Who doesn't want to date a flashy man? I'm sure you want to. When you think of the fact that you probably don't know what he's doing, you don't know the source of his income, or you're not 100% sure, or you have an idea that this guy is being shoddy or is being shady, and you trip your head there, whatever it is you see, you get it. And that's just the truth. So that's like my own opinion. I honestly do not want my own child to be paraded tomorrow as a fraudster, because there are people who work really hard, who come to work, my salary is never enough for me. In 2 or 3 days, my salary, like, what's today's date? Today's date is 14th. I'm not lying to you, I've finished spending my salary for this month in my head. And it's not with me already. But already in my head, salary is over. You know, woman wants an Insta table, but come on. There are people who are actually trying to make legit living. So when you come out on social media to make excuses for fraudsters, they've actually finished some people. They've cleared accounts. People have checked, people woke up one morning, looked at their accounts, didn't see money, and probably collapsed and died. So it's a power, it's robbery. It's robbery, that's just the truth. The robbery is just that you have to use your sense and your computer to do it. So I think we need to, I don't know, educate ourselves, and certain things are just wrong. What is wrong is wrong. There's nothing about, oh, it's a snitch, this is not snitching. He mentioned nobody's name. He just said, okay, this is what's happening in the society. So this is not a matter of anyone's nature. It's about our society. Because at the end of the day, you're saying all these things. We are all going to have children. At one point or the other, we'll leave our children. And the society is getting really, really horrible. As in, I don't know. I'm just here wondering, what will our children meet in this country? Absolutely nothing. I really don't know. We need divine intervention, maybe with divine intervention now, because they've said, okay, we keep saying God, 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 God. I don't know what we need in this country, but it's actually really, and the youths are, you know, if you looked at Twitter in the last, even Instagram, don't look at Twitter, go to Insta Blog Ninja, the comments on this first step, and just go and read the comments and see people making excuses for it. It's actually very appalling. Anyway guys, I'm going to leave you guys with a video of D1. I found it really funny. I know, I'm sure it was coincidental. According to him, it was coincidental. But you know, it makes sense. It makes sense because what's been trending on Twitter in the last 3 days or 2 days was sugar mommy or work and everything. And it just makes sense. So I'll leave the video. And thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you. If there's anything you want to talk about, let me know. Write in the comments section or send me email laurasbox@gmail.com. My Instagram is laurasbox, Twitter laurasbox, every other thing is laurasbox. So thanks for watching. If you've not subscribed, if you never subscribe, press the subscribe button. It is very easy, just use the subscribe button. So that's just it. So I'll leave you with this video. Thank you so much. See you next time. Bye.
Hello guys, most of you have been wondering, where have I been, man? I've been really busy working, going on tour, different shows around the globe. I've been traveling, it's been crazy. Even endorsements, everything. I've just been trying to pick the one that, you know, I'll go for. It's just been crazy. It's not easy to make millions, I swear.
Hey, have you washed the plate? Have you swept the floor? You have not even washed my pants. You are there 3 million. Because this washing my pants, one that can guarantee your millions and endorsement. So you are there wasting your time.
Calm down now. She be out. I'll wash the pan. I've soaked it already. It's just to wash it.
Just go and wash it. Because that is what can guarantee your millions. Not this video you are doing.
All the sugar mommy stuff.